Now see, in this question you have to find the value of n. It's clear. So first of all, what will you do? You make single logarithm in both the sides. In both sides, you make single logarithm. Single logarithm means there is one term of log and there is no number before that. So see here, this bracket you can see, this is log 5 minus log 3. So we can write it in this way. See, within bracket we can write log m minus log n. What can you write this? Who will tell? Log 5 minus log 3. What can you write this?
Sir, log 5 by 3.
Log 5 by 3. We will apply the quotient law of logarithm in the reverse order. So it will be log 5 upon 3 minus the other bracket. In the other bracket also you can apply the quotient rule. But first you have to remove this 2. ये जो 2 है इसको हटाना है. एंड हाउ विल यू रिमूव? यू ब्रिंग दिस 2 ऑन द पावर ऑफ 6. ब्रिंग दिस 2 ऑन द पावर ऑफ 6. सो इट इज लॉग 6 स्क्वायर 2 माइनस लॉग n. इट इज क्लियर? नाउ यू कैन सी हियर 3. Log 5 upon 3 minus, what will you write this bracket? Who can tell?
Minus log 5 plus 30 plus log 36.
Minus, yes, tell once again.
Minus log 5 plus log 36.
No. You log will not open the bracket. Here you will simplify by applying quotient law of logarithm. Logarithm ka quotient law lagana hai. Quotient law kya hai? Log m minus log n equals to log m upon n. So it is also in the same way. Log m minus log n equals to log m upon n, 5 upon 6 square. This 2 you can write 2 log 10 minus log n. It's clear? Because 2 is not in logarithm, so you can write 2 log 10. And as you know that log 10 equals to 1, therefore there will be no change in the value. Now see here. Here 3 you bring on the power of base. 3 ko base ki power mein laate. So it is 5 upon 3 whole to the power 3 minus log 5 upon 36 equals to log 10 square minus log n. So this will be 125 upon 27 minus log 5 upon 36 equals to log 100 minus log n. Now once again you can apply the quotient rule in both the sides. In both sides you will apply the quotient rule. So this is log m minus log n means log m upon n. So this will be log 125 upon 27 divided by 5 upon 36 equals to, this you can write log 100 upon n. Now simplify.
चल रही ना, अभी तो शुरू हुई है.
Now what will happen? It is the fraction divided by fraction. Therefore, this fraction which is in denominator, it will reciprocate and multiply. So 36 upon 5 equals to log 100 upon n. Now you further simplify. When you will further simplify, you can see here. This is 5 1 ja 5 25 ja, 9 3 ja 9 4 ja. So it will be log 100 upon 3, and this is log 100 upon n. So on comparing, because both the logarithms are same, are equal, both the logarithms are equal, therefore their bases will be equal. Unke base kya honge? Barabar honge. Therefore n equals to. Have you understood? This is question number 8. So this is the question number 11. Now see here. So in most of the questions, you have to make single logarithm and then solve. You make single logarithm and then you will solve. You can see some more questions here. You can see here. Question number 12. Log y to the base 10 plus 2 log x to the base 10 equals to 2. Now you can see here, in left hand side you make single log. In right hand side also you can make. But here I will not convert right hand side in the logarithmic form. And you can see here, though we can do by that way also, by making this right hand side writing in the logarithmic form. So first you make single logarithm in left hand side. So how will you remove this 2? Who can tell? Arnav Tiwari.
Sir, in power, sir, log
you 10 base x square. On the power of base. Bring this 2 on the yes, power sir. Of base. So it will be log x square to the base 10 equals to 2. Now, Nandini Garg. Now, what will you write in the next step? Which rule you will apply? Law? Which law you will apply? Nandini Garg. IUC Agrawal. Now, all of you answer also without answering.
Log by base 10 plus the x square.
Log y plus x square. No.
Sorry, log y upon
log
5 into x square.
Vatsala.
Yes.
Vatsala. Tarun Tripathi. Here we can apply product law. And in product law, what will you write? Log m plus log n equals to log m into n. log m into n to the base 10 equals to 2. It is log m into n to the base 10. Now I'm writing in exponential form. I'm writing in exponential form. Y into x square equals to 10 to the power 2. 10 to the power 2 equals to y into x square. So what will be y in terms of x? It will be 100, because 10 square is 100. 100 upon x square. 100 upon x square. Now see here. Now question number 14. Here it is given a square equals to log x to the base 10. B cube equals to log y to the base 10. You have to find, and this is also given, a square upon 2 minus cube upon 3 equals to log z to the base 10. You have to express z in terms of x and y. Z ki value humko x aur y ke terms mein nikalni. All these things are given. So what will you do in the next step? In place of a square, here you write this. In place of b cube, you write this. So you write down, it is 1 upon 2. In place of a square, log x to the base 10 minus 1 by 3 log y to the base 10 equals to log z to the base. It's clear. Now see here, it is log x ki power 1 by 2 to the base 10 plus log y to the power 1 by 3 to the base 10 equals to log z to the base 10. Now this is like log m plus log n, means log m into n. Therefore log x to the power 1 by 2 into y ki power 1 by 3 to the base 10 equals to,
sir, to the,
yes
sir, there is minus sign before 1 by 3 log y to the base 10.
This is minus sign. Yes, very good. This is minus sign. So what will happen? It will be this upon this. It's clear. This, all of you see here. Here there was minus, so therefore here also minus. Have you understood? So
yes,
now,
sir.
Divide it by. It will go into division. Quotient rule will apply. So I am writing once again this term, log x to the power 1 by 2 upon y to the power 1 by 3 to the base 10. Equals to log z to the base 10. When you will compare, on comparing, because logarithms are equal, therefore on comparing basis, when you will compare base, it will be z x ki power 1 by 2 upon y ki power 1 by 3. This. Have you understood? Bole. Now all of you see here. Question number 17. Here it is given if log x upon 2 equals to log y upon 3, you have to find the value of y to the power 4 upon x to the power 6. This value you have to find. So see here, on cross multiply. Now, what is the meaning of cross multiplying? इधर का denominator उधर के numerator से multiply होगा और इस side का denominator इधर के numerator से. This is the cross multiplication, मतलब cross बनेगा. Yes, this way. इधर का denominator उस तरफ के numerator से, इधर का denominator उधर के numerator से. So it is 3 log x upon 2 log y. Now you carry these numbers which are before logarithm in the powers of base. X cube equals to log y square. Since the logarithms are equal, therefore, on comparing bases, x cube equals to y square. Now, see here, you have to find this value. So, y to the power 4 upon x to the power 6 means y square का होल स्क्वायर अपॉन x की पावर 6. Now here in place of y square you write down x cube. That is x cube होल स्क्वायर अपॉन x to the power 6. Equals to 1. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now see the question number 18. Here you have to find solve for x. Means you have to find the value of x. And it is also very simple. In every question, you try to make single logarithm. When you will make single logarithm, it will be solved. See here, it is log x to the base 3 minus log 2 to the base 3 equals to 1. It is of what type? Log m minus log n. You know this formula, log m minus log n equals to log m upon n. So you apply this formula, what will you get? Log x upon 2 to the base 3 equals to 1. Now on writing in exponential form. So it will be 3 key power 1 equals to x by 2. Or x by 2 equals to 3. Therefore, x equals to 6. X equals to 6. It is clear? Now there is one more way of solving this. You can see here. Here I have not made right hand side in logarithmic form, not right written right hand side in logarithmic form. You can see here, you can write it in logarithmic form, but see here, here base is 3. तो जब इधर हम लिखेंगे तो 3 बेस पर ही लिखेंगे. So see here you can see it is log x by 2 to the base 3. अब एक लॉगरिथमिक टर्म ऐसा यहां पर लिखें जिसकी वैल्यू 1 हो और बेस इज 3. So you know logarithm of any same number as base is 1. We will write 3 to the base 3. It is clear? Suppose yes, if it is 2 here, agar yahan 2 hota, hum kya likh dete? 2 log 3 to the base 3 and then 2 yahan le aate. But yahan to aisa hai nahi. So it is log 3 to the base 3. So I'm comparing x by 2 equals 2. So x equals to x will be 6. Are you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now see here. Now question number 18, fourth part. So log 8 upon log 2 into log 3 upon log square root 3 equals to 2 log x. Now see here, you simplify here. 8 you can write 2 cube upon log 2 into log 3. And this you can write log 3 ki power 1 by 2. When you will remove the square root, power will be 1 by 2. And 2 log x, so it can be written as log x square. On further simplifying, 3 log 2 upon log 2 into log 3. And this can be written as 1 by 2 log 3 equals to log x square. This we have simplified by using power rule. What is power rule? Log m to the power n equals to n log m. N log m. So you can see here. Here log 2. Log 2 cancel. Log 3. Log 3 cancel. When you will further simplify this 1 by 2, 3 into 2 by 1. Equals to log x square. Means log x square equals to 6. Now you have to find the value of x. So you can see here, here there is no base. And if the base is not given, then base is taken 10. What is base? Base is taken 10. So you take the base as 10. You can write. So I'm writing in exponential form. Writing in exponential form. What will be in exponential form? X square equals to 10 ki power 6. X square equals to 10 ki power 6. You have to find the value of x. तो ये पावर हम उधर ले जाएं, तो जब पावर उधर जाएगी तो क्या हो जाएगी, उस साइड की पावर के डिनोमिनेटर, उस साइड की पावर के डिनोमिनेटर, means it is 10 की पावर 3. Are you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, after question number 18, I will do 20 seconds. In between 19, 20, 21, you do by your own. If you don't get these questions, you can ask in the next lecture. Here also, you have to solve for x. And how will you solve for x? By making single logarithm in both the sides. By making single logarithm in both the sides. Here you can see here, log. This is, I am taking third part. 10x plus 5 minus log equals to 2. It's clear. So we can apply the quotient rule. It will be log 10x plus 5 upon x minus 4. And this you can write 2 log 10 because log 10 is 1. Log 10 is 1, so it will be, can be written this. In next step, we can write log 10 square means log 100. So if you see, left hand side is this, right hand side is this. Both the logarithms are equal. Therefore, on equating the bases, when you will equate base, 10x plus 5 upon x minus 4 equals to 100. So 10x plus 5 equals to 100 into x minus 4. On further simplifying, 10x plus 5 equals to 100x minus 4. Now 10x you take in that side, 400 in this side. Minus 10x means 90x equals to 405. So what will be x here? It is 405 upon 90. So it will be equal to 518 ja, and then 58 ja 1. Then 92 ja 99 ja. So what is x here? I am writing here only. X equals to 9 by 2. So, in question number 22, 23, up to 23, you can solve by making single logarithm in both the sides. By making single logarithm in both the sides, you can solve. Single logarithm means, all of you be very clear, means there is no number before here, logarithm. Logarithm ke pahle koi number na, like this. Now see here, I am taking one more question here. The questions are very simple. Question number 21. 27 e power log 2. That you have to prove 8 e power log 3. These two you have to prove equal. So first you see here 27 means 27 is 3 cube. So 3 to the power 3 whole ki power log 2. And 8 you can write 2 ki power 3 whole ki power log 3. Therefore 3 ki power 3 log 2. And 2 ki power 3 log 3. It's clear? This is. Now on taking logarithms in both sides. On taking logarithm in both sides. So when you will take logarithm, it will be log 3 e power 3 log 2 equals to log 2 e power 3 log 3. Now, in both sides, you can apply power rule. So, power rule mein kya hota? Log m to the power n equals to n log m. Means power term comes before logarithm. Power ka term logarithm ke pehle aata hai. So 3 log 2 into log 3 equals to 3 log 3 into log 2. Now on rearranging the terms, 3 log 2 into log 2. This I will write as it is, but right hand side we will rearrange. So first you write 3 if there is. So yes, there is 3. So you write down 3. Then you write down the term of log 2 if it is present in that side. So yes, it is also present. Log 2 into log 3. Hence proved. Both the sides are same. Therefore it is proved. It's clear? Now question number 20. Here you can see the very less time is left. I'll have to see quickly. Question number 20. Here it is given log x upon log 5 equals to log y square upon log equals to log 9 upon log 1 by 3. Here you have to find the value of x and y. So first we will simplify this term. When you will simplify this term, it will be log 9 square is log 3 square. And this we can write log 1 minus log 3. But as we know that log 1 equals to 0. Therefore, it will become log 3 square 2 log 3. And 0 minus log 3 means only minus log 3. So when it is cancelled, it will become minus 2. Means this whole term has become minus 2. It means log x upon log 5 equals to minus 2. You can write further log x equals to minus 2 log 5. Log 5 you multiply in this side. Now this minus 2 power you take in the base power. So log 5 ki power minus 2 and it is log x. So what is x here? 5 ki power minus 2 means 1 upon 5 square. That is 1 upon 25. X equals to 1 upon 25. Similarly, you can find this. So all of you do up to the question number 23. Up to question number 23, all of you do. It's clear? And all of you keep doing your work on classwork notebook, homework notebook.